Hello all and welcome back to my channel. My name is Chandramani Pandey and thank you very much for watching my other videos. I am hoping that my videos are adding some values in your day-to-day Intune operation work. Please consider subscribing my channel. By subscribing, you will get access to new videos as soon as they are uploaded, and it's a great way to stay up to date with my content and support me at the same time. Now let's take a look at the Intune interview question series schema. So as you may be aware of it, I have already published a video on Microsoft Intune interview preparation guide where I explained how you can prepare for an Intune interview and the type of question you can expect in the Intune interview. Throughout this series, I will be covering the following topics and will provide questions and answers on each topics. And these topics are Windows device enrollment, application deployment, Windows patch management in Intune, Windows autopilot, compliance and configuration profile, and other related topics. For each topic, I will be creating two videos, with each videos containing close to 25 questions. These questions will include a mixture of short questions, long questions, and scenario based questions. In this part 2 video, I will be focusing on Windows device enrollment question and answer. So before we begin, if you are new to my channel or yet not subscribed my channel, please consider subscribing my channel and turn on the notification so that you won't miss any of my videos. The very first question is, what is device enrollment in Microsoft Intune? So device enrollment in Intune refers to the process of enrolling and managing devices such as smartphones, tablet and computers in Microsoft Intune, which is a cloud-based service for managing and securing devices and applications. So device enrollments allow organization to establish a connection between their device and the Intune service, enabling administrator to apply policies, configure settings, and distribute application to those devices. During the enrollment process, devices are enrolled with Intune and assigned a unique Intune device ID. This identity enables administrator to apply policies and configuration specific to the enrolled devices. There are different methods of device enrollment in Intune, and depending on the device platform and management requirement, we can use those methods. So the very first method is user enrollment. This method is primarily used for managing personal devices, also known as BYOD, bring your own device. In a corporate environment with user enrollment, user can enroll their own devices into the Intune while keeping their personal data and privacy separate from the corporate data. Administrator can manage corporate applications and policies without having complete control on the device. The second method is the device enrollment. This method is suitable for corporate-owned devices where organizations have full control over the device and can apply extensive management policies. Device enrollment is typically used for company-owned devices such as dedicated work phone, tablets, and Windows PC. Administrator can enforce security policy, manage application, and remotely control the device. And the third one is the automated device enrollment. This enrollment is available for device running for Windows 10 and Windows 11. It enables organization to enroll device into Intune automatically during the initial setup phase. Automated device enrollment streamlines the enrollment process for large-scale deployment, allowing device to be pre-configured with necessary settings and policies before they reach to the end user. Now the next question is, what are the different methods to enroll Windows device in Intune? So we can broadly classify Intune enrollment methods for Windows devices into two categories. First one is the user can self-enroll their Windows devices
And second one is the administrator can configure policies to force automatic enrollment without any user involvement. So with respect to user can self enroll their Windows devices, we have four options, and those options are bring your own device, also known as BYOD, which is used to enroll their personal devices. Second one is the MDM only enrollment method, in which the device is only enrolled in Intune. Third one is the Azure Active Directory join method, in which device is first joined to the Azure Active Directory and automatically enroll in the Intune. And the fourth one is the autopilot. With respect to second type of enrollment method, in which user involvement is not required, admin has to create the policies or configuration to automatically enroll the devices in Intune. We can use hybrid Azure AD join enrollment method, in which we have to create a group policy to automatically enroll the device in Intune. We can also use the configuration manager in co-manage environment to automatically enroll the device in Intune. We can also use the device enrollment manager to enroll the device in Intune. And last one is the bulk enrollment method, in which we have to create a package using Windows Configuration Designer to enroll the device in bulk. Now the next question is, what is bulk enrollment method in Intune? So bulk enrollment method is a admin driven enrollment method, in which admin creates a provisioning package by using Windows Configuration Designer app. By applying the provisioning package to corporate owned device, joins the device to your Azure Active Directory tenant and enroll them for Intune management. Once the provisioning package is applied, it's ready for your Azure Active Directory user to sign in. Bulk enrollment is considered as a userless enrollment method, and because of it, only the default enrollment restriction in Intune would apply during the enrollment phase. Bulk enrollment provisioning package is only valid for 6 months because of bulk AAD token expiry. We can use dism.exe tool or PowerShell command to install the package, and there are some other methods also to install the provisioning package. So there are some prerequisites to enroll a Windows device using bulk enrollment method. And these are, device should be Windows 11 or Windows 10 creator update with build version 17.09 or later. And we have to enable the Windows automatic enrollment. Now the next question is, how we can create a bulk enrollment package or provisioning package? So to create a bulk enrollment package or provisioning package, first, we have to download the Windows Configuration Designer app from the Microsoft Store. Then we must open the Windows Configuration Designer app and select the provisioning desktop device and create a new project. In the device setup step, we have to enter a unique name for your device. Names can include a serial number or a random set of characteristics. Optionally, we can also enter a product key if we want to upgrade the edition of Windows. We can also configure a device to be used as a shared device and also remove the pre-installed softwares. Optionally, we can configure the Wi-Fi device connection to when they first start. If the network device are not configured, a Wi-Fi connection is required when the device is first started. Then we have to select the enrollment in Azure Active Directory and enter a bulk token expiry date, and then select get bulk token by providing Azure Active Directory credential to get a bulk token. The bulk token validity period is 180 days. The account used to request the bulk token must be included in the MDM user scope that is specified in the Azure Active Directory, and then click next when bulk token is fetched successfully. Optionally, we can add applications, add certificates. These apps and certificates are provisioned on the device during enrollment time. Optionally, we can password protect our provisioning package, and then we have to click create and package is now ready for the enrollment. for provisioning a device, we have to access the provisioning package in the location specified in the project folder specified in the application. And then provisioning package can be applied to a device by many ways. Like we can place the provisioning package on a USB drive, insert the USB drive into the device you would like to bulk roll, and then apply it during the initial setup. We can also provision a package on a network folder and apply it after initial setup. We can also use DISM or PowerShell command to install the package. After you apply the package, device will automatically restart in 1 minute. And when the device restarts, it connects to the Azure Active Directory and enroll the device in Microsoft Intune automatically. Now the next question is, what is Device Enrollment Manager and its advantage? So a Device Enrollment Manager is a non-administrator user who can enroll a device in Intune. Device Enrollment Manager are useful to have when you need to enroll and prepare many devices for distribution. People signing into a device account can enroll and manage up to 1000 devices, while a standard non-admin account can only enroll 15 devices. A Device Enrollment Manager account requires an Intune user or device license and an associated Azure Active Directory user. Global administrator and Intune service administrator can add and manage the Device Enrollment Manager in Microsoft Intune Admin Center portal. Device Enrollment Manager will Windows 10 or 11 devices in shared device mode, so device limit restriction won't work on them. We can create maximum 150 Device Enrollment Manager account in Microsoft Intune. A Device Enrollment Manager can use the following method to enroll a device in Intune. They can use a bulk enrollment using a provisioning package. They can enroll a device via company portal enrollment. They can also initiate an enrollment via Azure Active Directory join. Now the next question is, what is automatic enrollment for Windows device and its advantage? So the automatic enrollment method in Microsoft Intune enables personal and corporate-owned device to enroll automatically when they join or registered in your Azure Active Directory tenant. Automatic enrollments can be used in following device management and provisioning scenario. We can use automatic enrollment method in case of bring your own device method. We can use while using a bulk enrollment or group policy or using a Windows autopilot. Even we can use the automatic enrollment method for co-management with configuration manager. So there are some prerequisites to enable the automatic enrollment, and these are: we require Azure Active Directory premium subscription and customized company branding. You should have a Microsoft Intune subscription and global administrator permission to enable the automatic enrollment. Now the next question is, what are the prerequisites to enroll the device using automatic enrollment via MDM scope? So to enroll device using automatic enrollment via MDM scope, there are several prerequisites that needs to be fulfilled, and here are the main prerequisites. The very first one is, admin should enable the MDM scope. Device restriction and limitation should be configured. It should be on 17.09 or above version, and the edition should be either Pro, Enterprise or Education. User should have Azure Active Directory account in enable state. User should be allowed to enroll the device in Azure Active Directory. User should have Azure Active Directory P1 or P2 license as well as the Microsoft Intune license. And last, there should be proper internet connectivity. Now the next question is, what are the common locations to find the Windows device enrollment traces for troubleshooting? So there are some common locations where we can find the enrollment traces. Like we can check access work or school settings whether the device is enrolled in Intune or not. We can check the registry locations to see who enrolled the device in Intune and other settings. we can also check the event viewer to see whether the device is enrolled via user account or device account. We can also check the MMC to ensure that the device having the proper certificates received from Azure Directory as well as the Intune. We can also run a command called dsregcmd/status to check the detailed information about the enrollment, and we can also ensure that the proper task schedulers are also created after enrolling a device in Intune. Now the next question is, what is Windows Configuration Designer application and its use? So Windows Configuration Designer is a tool to create and configure provisioning package. So Windows Configuration Designer comes with a benefit such as quickly configuring the device without having any network connectivity, saving time and avoiding installing new images on devices. So there are several steps in Windows Configuration Designer to create a provisioning package. Under Setup Device step, we can configure the name. We can enter the product key to upgrade the Windows edition. We can configure the device for shared use, and we can also remove the pre-installed software. Under Setup Network step, we can connect the device to a Wi-Fi network. Under Account Management, we have several options such as enroll into Azure Directory, enroll into Azure AD. We have option for creating local account as well. We can add application certificates and protect the provisioning package with strong passwords. Next question is, can we change the Intune device primary user? If yes, how? So primary user, also known as user device affinity, is a property of each Intune device. An Intune device can have 0 or 1 primary user assigned to it. When there is no primary user assigned, the device is referred to as a shared device. We can change the primary user from user A to user B. We can change the primary user from non or shared device to a single user device. We can also change the primary user from a single user to non or shared devices. So there are some important points when we are talking about primary user. The first one is that device must be running on the supported version of Windows 10 or Windows 11. Device can either be Azure Directory join or hybrid Azure AD join. We cannot change the primary user for Azure Directory registered devices. We can now change our device primary user for a co-managed device also. To change or remove the primary user of a device requires the permission manage devices set primary user. Changing the primary user does not change the enrolled by users in Intune. And last, a user must have an Intune license to be assigned as a primary user. We can manually change the primary user from Intune console under the properties section, or for bulk device we can use a PowerShell script or via Graph API. The very first question is, what is the advantage of Azure Directory P1 or P2 license in device enrollment? So there are multiple security benefits of using Azure Directory P1 or P2 license. But if you are asking about the Intune point of view, then without P1 P2 license, we cannot enable automatic enrollment feature, which is used to automatically enroll any Azure Directory registered or joined device in Intune. Next question is, DEM accounts can enroll how many devices in Intune and how many DEM accounts we can create? So DEM accounts can enroll up to 1000 devices, and we can only create 150 DEM accounts in Intune. Next question is, what is device enroller.exe and its use and its location? So device enrollment.exe, also known as an API for MDM enrollment file. This is the by default exe present in all Windows 10 and Windows 11 devices. Device is using enrollment.exe to enroll the device in Intune, and the location of device enroller.exe is under C, Windows System 32, and then we have a device enroller.exe. Now the next question is how we can block enrollment of a personal owned device. So to block the enrollment of a personal owned device, we must go to the devices, and under devices we have to go to the enrolled devices and we have to configure the enrolled device platform restriction. Next question is how we can block the enrollment of a specific device platform. So to block the enrollment of a specific device platform, again we have to go to the devices, and under devices we have to go to the enrolled devices, and within enrolled devices we have an option called enrolled device platform restriction, and we have to restrict the specific device platform to enroll in Intune. Next question is how we can limit the number of device enrollment in Intune. So to limit the number of device enrollment in Intune, we have to create a device limit restriction policy, and we have to configure that the maximum allowed device enroll in Intune is 15, and as per our requirement we can configure the device limit. And to configure that, we have to go to the devices, and within devices we have to go to the enrollment restrictions, and we have to create a restriction policy, and we have to configure the device limit under the restriction policy. Next question is what is the maximum number of device user can enroll in Intune. As I said that the maximum limit is 15, but if the restriction is created for 5, then user can only enroll the 5 devices. Now the next question is what are the options we must use to enroll join device in Intune. So we can use group policy object or configuration manager in co-manage environment to enroll the domain join device in Intune. Now next question is what is the difference between authentication and authorization. So in simple terms, authentication is the process of verifying who a user is, while authorization is the process of verifying what they have access to. Now the next and last question is what is the maximum number of device user can join in Azure directory. So Microsoft recommendation is 20 devices, but we can enroll unlimited devices in Azure directory. Now the next question is a scenario based question, and the scenario is we are currently working on a project that requires enrolling 1000 devices. In addition to device enrollment, client requirement is to configure the device for shared use and want to install around 20 core applications. What would be the most effective method to achieve this objective? Since the requirement is to enroll 1000 devices, also ensuring they are suitable for shared uses, and we must install the core application during the enrollment process, we can utilize the bulk enrollment method to achieve this objective. Now the next scenario based question is user is trying to enroll the device in Intune using the Azure AD join enrollment method. However, every time the device successfully joins to the Azure directory, but it does not enroll in Intune. How we can fix this enrollment issue? Because the machine is able to join in Azure directory, but not able to enroll in Intune, we should verify the Intune license assigned to the user. We should verify auto enrollment enabled for all users. And if it is enabled for some users, then the user must be a part of some group. We should verify the enrollment restriction as well as the device version and edition. And we have to verify all the necessary URLs are allowed to join the device in Intune. Now the next question is, due to any reason, one of the client environment does not have an Azure directory premium P1 or P2 license. What method we can use to enroll the device in this environment? Since client does not have a Azure directory P1 and P2 license, we can utilize the MTM only enrollment method, or we can enroll the device via company portal.
I hope this is an informative video for you. Thank you very much for watching this video.